But of course, gold also remains a spot of health, a spot of good health as far as precious metals go. But let's bring in Prathamesh Mallya as well. He's chief analyst, non-agri commodities and currencies at Angel Broking. He joins us now. Prathamesh, good to have you. Let's start with your strategies on precious metals. You have a buy call on both silver and gold.
Yes, we prefer to be on the buy side for both these metals. Although it looks like the rally seems to be topped out, we might possibly see some correction on the cards. However, till that time, North Korea, US, and all the nuclear related reports come into array, we still be on the buy side for the precious metals. And in Indian markets, possibly 30,500 is something which looks near term targets as far as gold is concerned. As far as silver goes, 41,900 or possibly 42,000 is the near term targets that you look you can look at for both these metals.
All right, what about crude oil? I mean, we saw a strong up move in yesterday's session, and you have a buy call with a target of 3190. Till what duration do you expect some near-term strength?
I think now is the hurricane season started, as you rightly spoke in the session before that. Hurricane Irma with the category 5 intensity, and this would possibly disturb furthermore refining capacity. And up till now, almost around quarter of the refining capacity in the US is still offline, which is something really positive for oil prices. However, we see this positive momentum just capped till 3200, and we will look for furthermore reports depending on how EIR data, inventory data prints in today.
All right. So I'll ask Ken Prathamesh, what is the time? I mean, you have a target of 3190. So this is still, I mean, this is an intraday call, or is it till tomorrow? What's the time horizon?
You can do this trade for at least 2 to 3 trading sessions. You would possibly see that move.
Okay, understood. So in industrial metals, what we are seeing is today that there is some cool off that we are witnessing. So zinc, I think, has cooled off almost 3%. This is about the Shanghai exchange. Copper is down a little, 0.3%. Aluminium is down 1%. And on the LME, we've seen nickel as well as lead receding. Is this just a brief correction that was long overdue, or do you think that we are likely to remain in a range and some kind of sluggish trading action can be seen after several weeks of a strong run, Prathamesh? First, a general comment.
A general comment on the base metals, I mean, all the base metals have rallied quite a bit and quite at a faster pace. So one correction looks likely, although it looks like a little bit of consolidation seems to be on the cards, and you will find prices correcting. Zinc and nickel especially will correct at a faster pace in compared to all the metals. We still remain bullish on copper. 454 still looks to be on the cards, while as far as zinc is concerned, 195 is the possible level where it can correct towards. It is currently trading at 200 mark.
All right, you have a buy call on copper then with a target of 454. So take us through the time horizon for this.
It would be same again, 2 to 3 trading sessions. So, but I think 450, 452 is possibly the exit points when you can trade on copper. If you want to have fresh entry in this particular country, it would be risky. So trade according to the risk appetite.
Fair point, Prathamesh. And we cannot obviously let you go before getting your view on what you feel about currencies. The Governing Council of the ECB meets in Frankfurt tomorrow. I mean, most of the street is anticipating that they might not hear anything material or concrete about the bond buying program being wound down. That probably could come in October. But the euro has already strengthened to 1.2, then cooled off a little. Do you think that there is some more near-term correction that we could see on the euro, and thereby some near-term support or buoyancy on the dollar index? Or do you think that there's only one way to go, that's the euro keeps strengthening and the dollar index keeps weakening from here?
I think you spoke that things correctly. Dollar keeps weakening and euro keeps strengthening is something which is possibly happening, and this would continue to happen. Dollar index 98 briefly touched 91.6 mark, which we spoke in our earlier interviews. It would possibly touch 90, but I would some way see that 90 dollar index again would possibly find support here and would possibly rally towards 95. But you really have to look what kind of set of fundamental factors pitch in for the movement of dollar index. But if you're talking about dollar and rupee as such, is spot is trading at 64.2. We see this moving higher towards 64.5. So near-term targets for rupee would be around 64.5.
Fair point, Prathamesh. We're going to leave it at that. But thank you so much for joining in and giving us an exhaustive lowdown on what you feel about crude oil, your strategies on precious metals, as well as your preference for copper and the view on global currencies and the rupee.